here is the interesting part on FTZs, foreign trade zones. You may recall that if you transfer it to foreign territory, drawback is eligible only to on exports to foreign territory. We saw that foreign territory is a term of art. Foreign territory, for example, includes the Guantanamo Bay Naval Station, but it does not include the Guam, let's say, or U.S. Virgin Islands, right? It's not a foreign territory. So going back to our foreign trade zones discussion, we saw that foreign trade zone is a zone within the customs territory of the United States, but it is really not part of the customs territory of the United States. It's kind of like a legal fiction where you can have certain things done. And within the foreign trade zones, you have something which is called various statuses, right? So one of the status, and this is a review of the FTZ chapter. So those folks for whom this is brand new stuff, please go to the FTZ chapter and take a look at the provisions of the FTZ. But basically, FTZ, foreign trade zone, has various statuses. So one is non-privileged foreign. The other one is privileged foreign. The other one is domestic. And the other one is zone restricted. And the reason why you want to have those various provisions, various status provisions, status provisions under the foreign trade zone is goes to the question of what do you want to use the foreign trade zone in the first place for, right? So non-privileged versus privileged refers to the valuation and classification of the product at the time of entry into the FTZ zone or the time of entry for consumption, right? For example, and this is the key, folks. If you bring the product as non-privileged under non-privileged foreign trade status, right, the duties and fees and the value of the product would be assessed when it will be at the time of entry. On a privileged foreign status, it would be under time of entry for consumption. Under the privileged foreign status, it would be at the time of the FTZ entry. And the reason for that is because, let's say, you bring in car parts. You bring in them into the FTZ, where you assemble them. And you make cars. And you bring him into the U.S. Customs territory of the United States. Consumption. You file entry for consumption. So let's say car parts are zero, but cars are 2.5%. use of FTZ as an instrument to see how much you want to pay will decide what type of status you want to get. Because if you can pay at the time of the FTZ, and if you choose to pay zero, right, you get it under the privilege status, as opposed to 2.5% at the time of entry, as you were not to assemble the cars, right? So the idea here is to take advantage, right? And this it goes in reverse too. Let's say the car parts were 2.5%, but the cars were duty free. Then you would use the, you want to bring it at under the privilege status, right, as opposed to the other one. So you can take advantage of the duty free provision as opposed to 2.5 provision. In other words, you play one status as opposed to another, and this is one of the reasons why you want to have FTZ in the first place, right? Zone restricted status, right? It has a sole purpose. The purpose of zone restricted status is exportation or destruction. There is exception, like the board ruling exception, where you can have a board ruling which can say, okay, it may not only be for that purposes, but here we're talking about the main rule. Domestic status means that it is either the stuff that were made in the United States or were imported and duty paid for in the United States. So that way you don't have to, you can use it with in the production, but do not go through the burden of paying duties and fees again upon the bringing the product back into the customs territory of the United States. So that's basic overview of various FTZ statuses. And the question, going back to our drawback discussion, what if you exported, can you export something to the FTZ, foreign trade zone, and claim the benefit of the drawback? And the answer is yes, so long as it is under this particular status. So drawback, you can do the drawback, but it must be this status. If it's under non-privileged foreign, privileged foreign or domestic, that's no go. And you kind of can kind of see that, because it's only for the exportation or destruction, right? Also, there is a storage provision too. So customs examiners have asked this question in the past. Merchandise transferred to a foreign zone, to a foreign trade zone, shall be given blank status in order to be considered exported for the purposes of drawback. So since we know that only this status is applicable for the purposes of getting a drawback under the FTZ provisions, foreign trade zone provisions, the zone restricted status here is the correct answer. But be mindful of all those other provisions, because under the FTZ questions, which show up with regular frequency on a customs broker exam, customs examiners do expect you to know the difference between those foreign trade zone statuses.